Hey everyone. Okay, so as I'm sure you've noticed, I've been making a lot of videos lately just kind of taking the piss out of modern liberal interpretations of how relationships should work. Kind of the more feminist, progressive view of, women don't really need men and men don't really need women. The destruction of the nuclear family and basically all the ideas that are popular in media today. And I do that because I think there needs to be a balancing. I think our throwing away of traditional values was kind of a throwing the baby out with the bathwater situation. And I really think we need to consider some of the statistics, some of the really important information about love and relationships and marriages that we got from time beforehand. Now, I don't usually respond to comments because in my opinion, comments don't represent what I say. However, I have gotten so many comments lately that have misinterpreted the message I am trying to put out there that it's gotten to a point where, unfortunately, I think I do need to address it. I could read some of the tweets I get, some of the comments I get, like, "Hey Lauren, why aren't you making videos with your five kids and your husband? How dare you say this as a woman without kids or a traditional marriage?" Or people saying, "All of these people are disgusting degenerates, and I hope they don't breed anyway," on my video asking young ladies if they would like a dog or kids or Netflix or a marriage. And this is not the kind of message I am trying to give out. I am not trying to sell an idea that myself as a 22-year-old needs to be married right now for the sake of traditionalism and not being a degenerate. No, in fact, I think it would be degenerate for me to get married right now without someone that I'm truly in love with and think could be a good father to my children. In fact, I think that would be significantly worse for the Western world. That would be significantly worse for my children to raise them as a single mother. As you know, they're more likely to commit suicide, more likely to be alcoholics, more likely to drop out of school, and it's just devastating growing up with a broken family. So I'm not going to get married at 22 years old just so that I won't be called a degenerate on the internet. What is also just completely shocking to me is the utter lack of understanding of nuance and the exception. I think people that ignore that there are exceptions to the rule are just as crazy as people who ignore there is a rule in the first place, in generals, and they exist, and we should talk in generalities so we can understand each other. But ignoring that there are exceptions is just as silly. Some women, yes, are going to be happier not having any kids. They are going to be happier not being married, and that's okay. That doesn't make them a horrible human being. That doesn't mean they have to be shamed for the rest of their life. The reason I talk about this isn't because I want people to feel terrible. It's because I want them to be happy. And on average, women and men are happy being married and with kids. On average, women are happy being housewives. And there are exceptions, and people need to accept that and think with just a little tiny bit of nuance. But it seems that some of the people who watch my videos, not all of them, I get some wonderful comments and some lovely comments from people who say, "Oh, I don't know if I'll ever get married, but I like that you're giving this advice." From people that are mothers that say, "Wow, I know you're not a mother yet, but I hope you're happy and become a mother one day and have a successful relationship." And they're beautiful comments, but then there are some people that just come in and think the only purpose of advocating traditionalism is have a kid right now because that is your biological duty. No, that's insane. The reason I love the West, the reason I love the idea of family and children is because of love and connection and meaning. I mean, I'm still trying to figure this out myself as well. I'm 22 years old, and that may seem old to some hardcore traditionalists that I should have seven kids by now or something. But the reality is, we're living in a very different age right now, and a lot of us who are on the more conservative end of things are trying to, we're longing for an age we've never lived in, and we're trying to recreate something that we never grew up being taught or understood. We've been inundated with so much Marxist propaganda, we've been inundated with so much anti-relationship, anti-man, anti-marriage propaganda that it's hard for us to recreate this thing. It's hard for us to understand how to do relationships properly. And I'm figuring it out myself, and I want to bring you along on that journey of asking questions and looking at statistics and taking the piss out of the hardcore feminists and making fun of the just the silly things that they do. But the reality is that I'm gonna fail. People are going to mess up. Maybe I will end up a crazy cat lady when I'm 30. I hope that doesn't happen, and I'm going to fight for that not to happen and work really hard to make my relationships work. And I'm going to help try to help other people do that too. I just thought I would clarify that for some people who are angry at me and accusing me of being a hypocrite and all these things, which, by the way, being a hypocrite doesn't mean you're wrong. You can be hypocritical about a lot of things and still be saying things that are accurate. But I don't even think I'm hypocritical in that sense. Like I said, I'm 22 and we're all trying to figure this out. And my hope for everyone watching this video is just that you help people try to find happiness as well, because we're living in a crazy world that is falling apart with a lot of chaos and confusion. And some of us are going to combat that with humor like I have, and some of us are going to combat it with facts like I have in other cases. But the point of this is not to hate people, it's to help people. Thank you guys for watching.